Kim Jong Un slams Trump, President fires back with three perfect words making liberals furious. President Donald Trump is not one to take heat from anyone without directly addressing the issue, so when Kim Jong Un slammed the president, referring to him as an old lunatic, there was no way that Trump was going to let it slide without getting one of his classic jabs in there. Trump sent out a tweet not too long after Kim's insult with three perfect words for the dictator, which are now causing liberal Twitter users to lose their minds. President Trump is the king of firing out politically incorrect tweets, writing exactly how he feels and saying exactly what he wants. More times than not, his tweets make headlines, usually causing the left to freak out again and again. In addition, Trump has never been known to take crap from anybody, and North Korea's explosive leader Kim Jong-un is absolutely no exception. Neither men have ever been short for words, so it isn't all that unusual to see the two fire back and forth, but lucky for the US, Trump always gets the last laugh. Earlier in the week, Kim referred to Trump as an old lunatic, accusing him of trying to undermine North Korea's position in the world, and as you can imagine, Trump did not tread lightly after being called an old lunatic. Even while on his Asia tour, Trump found time to take a shot back at the little rocket man. Reckless remarks by an old lunatic like Trump will never scare us or stop our advance, the North's foreign ministry said in a statement, AP News reported. On the contrary, all this makes us more sure that our choice to promote economic construction at the same time as building up our nuclear force is all the more righteous, and it pushes us to speed up the effort to complete our nuclear force. Trump responded as soon as he had the opportunity, firing up his Twitter account to let Kim know exactly what he thought of the insult. In response to North Korea calling Trump's speech in South Korea reckless remarks by an old lunatic, Trump tweeted from Hanoi on Sunday morning, saying, "Why would Kim Jong-un insult me by calling me old, when I would never call him short and fat?" Trump goes on to sarcastically add, "Oh well, I try so hard to be his friend, and maybe someday that will happen." Of course, as soon as liberals got sight of the spat, they instantly predicted the mockery would lead to World War III. Ignoring the fact that Kim Jong-un has nuclear capabilities, which he's repeatedly tested as a show of force, they choose to blow this out of proportion. Sadly, they don't seem to realize that the possibility of World War III has been a threat long before Trump's tweet, and it has nothing to do with the president's remarks about Kim. One triggered snowflake wrote, "I was convinced that the Trump short and fat tweet was a fake. No, just checked his account, he actually tweeted this. I didn't think I could feel sadder and more scared for the world, but now I do," while another wrote, "With the short and fat tweet, it's time to number 25th Amendment Trump. He needs to go before our West Coast is smoking ash." Yeah, the words short and fat make these liberals sad, fearing smoking ash, but words like a nuclear threat and hydrogen bombs didn't seem to bother the leftists, who much like former President Barack Obama have just chosen to ignore the real danger. I guess we can expect some confusion from liberals since Obama's 8 years were spent belittling our own country and allowing world leaders to look down on us as he literally bowed to them, but finally, we have a president who is a superior leader and ready to face the problem head on. A tweet isn't going to start World War III. An unchecked, short and fat dictator will. If anything, it's a breath of fresh air not to see our commander-in-chief take a limp-wristed, butt-kissing approach with a kind of crazy coming out of North Korea.